Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I am going to solve a few problems on air compressors in applied thermal engineering, that is unit 5. I have selected two problems from the question bank. The first one is the first one in the question bank. It goes like this: a single cylinder, single acting reciprocating air compressor has a cylinder dia of 24 centimeter cylinder dia and a linear piston speed is 100 meters per minute, 100 meters per minute. It takes in air, that is P1 is 100 kilopascal and delivers at 1 megapascal, that is P2 is 1 megapascal, that means 1000 kilopascal. Kilopascal. Determine the indicated power, that is the power of the motor. Determine the indicator power of the compressor. We have to find out the power required to drive the assume the law of compression to be PV to the power of 1.25 is equal to constant. That means the value of N is, it is polytropic process, the value of N is 1.25. Take is equal to constant. Temperature of air at inlet is 288 degree Kelvin, that is T1 is 288 degree Kelvin. We don't require this. Neglect the clearance effect, that is neglect the clearance volume, he says. So we have to find out P. So to find out P, first I have to find out W. So W will be this thing here. Here this piston speed means this is 2ln. 2ln is piston speed. Now the formula for W is N by N minus 1 into P1 V1 into P2 by P1 whole to the power of N minus 1 by N minus 1. So many kilojoules per stroke. If you multiply it by N, you get W into N directly can be got from here. Now N is 1.25. This I'll do it one. N by N minus 1 into P1 into V1 into N. This N I will take here. Kone? Isko mai bol diya tha. So multiplied by P2 by P1 whole to the power of N minus 1 by N minus 1. Now this will be equal to W into N will be equal to N by N minus 1 into P1. This V1 is nothing but, if you neglect clearance volume, if VC is neglected, then V1 will be same as stroke volume. Stroke volume will be pi D square by 4 into L. So this is V1. This is V1. Is pi d square by 4 into L multiplied by N into P2 by P1 whole to the power of N minus 1 by N minus 1. Now you take this value, ln will be, ln will be, 2 ln is 100 meters per minute, so ln will be 50 meters per minute. So this will be 1.25 divided by 1.25 minus 1 into P1. P1 is 100 kilopascal, pi d is 0.24 meters, pi into 0.24 square divided by 4 into ln is 100 by 2, that is this is 50, multiplied by P2, 1000 divided by 10 whole to the power, 1000 divided by 100 whole to the power of 1.25 minus 1 divided by 1.25 minus 1. Now this works out to 1000 divided by 100 will be 10. This is 10 to the power of 0.25 divided by 1.25. 5 will be 0.2. This will be 0.2. So 10 to the power of 0.2 equals 1.58 something minus 1 equals 0.58. This works out to 0.58 into 50 into 0.24 square into pi divided by 4, then into 100 into 1.25 divided by 0.25, that will give me 661.5 kilojoules per minute. Kilojoules per minute. This is W into N. Now P will be W into N divided by 60 into efficiency. I think efficiency is not given, so I'll take it as 1. So this whole thing is 661.5 divided by 60 into 1. That works out to 11 kilowatts. 11 kilowatts. This is the power, that is the power of the motor which is should be fitted to the air compressor in order to get that. I hope you have understood this. We shall do one more problem on air compressors. I have selected problem number 4 from the question bank. It goes like this. It is desired to compress 17 cubic meter of air, 17 cubic meter of air per minute. That means this is V into N. Volume of air per stroke into number of strokes. This is V into N, is 17 cubic meters of air per minute from 1 bar. It is P1 is 1 bar, that is 100 kilopascals, to 7 bar. P2 is 7 bar, or it is 700 kilopascal. In a single stage, single acting air compressor, calculate the power required to drive the compressor and heat rejected during compression to cooling water of the compressor if the A, expansion is isentropic, that is PV to the power of gamma equals constant, and B, isothermal, or it can be called as PV is equal to constant. So these are the either one by this, two times we have to work out this. Now P, you know, P is what we want, is Wn divided by 60 into efficiency. Efficiency is not given, so we can assume that as 100% or 1, that will go. Now we have to find out Wn, this is V1 into N, will be equal to, first case it is isothermal, will be equal to P1 V1 into N into log of, this is isothermal, second case, if it is isothermal, log of P2 by P1 to base E. So W into N will be equal to, this P1 is 100, V1 into N is 17, into log of P2 is 700 divided by 100 to base E. So this will be equal to, that will be equal to, first you divide this by this, that will be 700 by 100 means 7, then in, you do one thing, in, that is log to base E of 7 is equal to 1.94 something into 17 into 100, that will be 3308 kilojoules per minute. Now P will be equal to W into N divided by 60 into efficiency. So 3308 divided by 60 into 1. So this answer divided by 60 will give me the power, that is 55 kilowatts. If it is done isothermally, according to this law, the power to be given is 55 kilowatts. If it is this one, PV to the power of gamma equals constant, the value of gamma is 1.4, because for air, we know that gamma ratio of specific heat is 1.4. So in the first case, it will be W into N will be equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 into P1 V1 N into P2 by P1 whole to the power of gamma minus 1 divided by gamma minus 1. So make the substitutions, 1.4 divided by 1.4 minus 1 into P1 is 100, V1 N is 17 into 700 by 100, that is 7 to the power of 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 minus 1. Now here, first this one, 0.4 divided by 1.4 gives me 0.285. This works out to 0.285. 7 to the power of 0.285 equals 1.74 something minus 1 equals, that is 0.74 into 17 into 17 into 100 into 1.4 divided by 0.4. This will give me 4410 kilojoules per minute. Then power is equal to W into N divided by 60 into efficiency, that is 4410 divided by 60 into 1. So this divided by 60 will give me 73.5. There it was 55 point something, here it is 73.5 kilowatts. This is the power to be supplied to the compressor in order to do the work by isentropic process. This is the first one. Okay, we have solved this problem. This is how it is to be done. I have done two problems. There are only four problems here. Out of that, I have solved two problems. If you have any other difficulty, you can always ask me to do it. We have done all the three, that is one isothermal, one isentropic, and one polytropic. The previous problem was polytropic process. That's how I have selected it. Now you can practice it, and if there is any problem, you can ask me on over phone. And I once again request you to subscribe the channel so that you will be getting the videos